Today, I'm going to show you how to create three types of maps in Microsoft Excel. A lot of people think that you need to download and install a plugin to create maps in Excel. But that's not true because Excel has some pretty neat built-in tools for creating customized maps already. I'll show you that today. All right, let's get started with creating Choropleth maps. So here I am in Microsoft Excel. I have a couple of worksheets open already. In each worksheet, I want to show you some examples of the types of maps you can create. Before we begin, I want to give you some background information on the mapping capabilities in Microsoft Excel. Excel has some predefined geographic areas built in for you to readily use in your maps. For example, if you want to show the population for the countries of the world, all you have to do for data preparation is enter the country and a value in the cell next to it. As you can see, that's exactly what I have in my spreadsheet. So in column A, I have countries of the world, and in column B, I have population. To create a map, all that I have to do is make a selection. Then just click the Insert ribbon. Finally, I can just click on the Maps button. It takes just a second or two to generate the map. As you can see, Excel has generated a map, and it recognized the column with the list of countries. So you don't need to download any geographic data or anything like that. Just enter the country name, and Excel will have its geographic boundary already built in. So that was a pretty simple example. Let's try another example, but something more challenging. Let's switch to the next tab, which contains zip codes. So in this tab, we have Colorado zip codes in column A. Then, in column B, we have population values. So let's see if Excel can recognize zip codes and create a map from it. Again, I'll highlight my data. Next, I'll click the Insert ribbon. Finally, I'll click the Maps button. It takes a bit of time to generate this map. All right, this looks pretty good. So zip codes work in Excel. Other geographic boundaries you can map include states, provinces, counties, postal codes, and many more. Now, I want to try something completely different. This time, I want to test the 3D functionality in Excel. Let's open the third spreadsheet. In this worksheet, I have the latitude and longitude coordinates of major cities in the United States. I also have a column for the population of each of these cities. I wonder if Excel can recognize these coordinates and add them to a 3D map. Let's give it a try this time. So you already know the first step. I'm going to click the Insert ribbon. But this time, I'm going to click the 3D Maps button. Keep in mind that if this is your first time using 3D maps in Excel, you might have to install it. But I've already done this, so my screen might look a bit different from yours. All right, so I'm going to pick New Tour. This will open a completely new interface to interact with your data. But you should pay close attention to the right panel. What you have to do is drag and drop fields into the right panel. So I am first going to drag and drop the latitude and longitude fields for the location. Next, I'm going to drag and drop the population field into the height. What this does is it creates a type of 3D bar chart in the map. For each city's latitude and longitude coordinates, the bar extrudes at a height based on the population field. So far, this is looking pretty good. My only complaint is that it's a bit hard to control tilting and panning on my globe. But I'm doing my best here to show you these 3D bars that it's generated in my map. Anyways, it's a pretty neat feature that not a lot of Excel users know today. So far, I've shown you Choropleth and 3D maps. The last type of map I want to show you are surface graphs. Surface graphs are useful for visualizing multiple dimensions of data. For instance, they can represent variables such as temperature, pressure, density, and volume. In our case, we're going to display elevation. So first, I'm going to highlight my data. Next, I'm going to click Recommended Charts. Then, I'll go into the All Charts tab. Finally, I will select Surface and 3D Surface. What you see here is a map that we use all the time in GIS, and it's called a triangulated irregular network. All right, so surface graphs create a three-dimensional map with the positions in the X and Y axis, and in the Z axis, it's displaying elevation. So it's quite a useful map for showing multiple variables. Excel Maps offer customizable options to work with location data within the familiarity of the Microsoft Excel environment. The three types of maps you can create are Choropleth Maps, 3D Maps, and Surface Graphs. Although you can't get the same versatility that you can from GIS software, you still can produce some effective maps. And don't forget, if you're still looking for other Microsoft products with mapping capabilities, Power BI has a range of options to integrate with GIS data and web feeds. Alright, that's about all that I have today in this video. Remember to write us a comment below if you have any questions. Also, don't forget to like and subscribe to our channel for more GIS tutorials. I'll see you next time.